guys, it's Susan and Kat, and today we're going to walk you through a short little 15-minute lower body routine using one of our most favorite exercises in the world, which is the squat. Show you a number of different squat variations in this workout. So it'll be about 15 minutes long, and it'll be a good sweaty routine for us to get us going for the weekend.
I'm ready to die.
Awesome. All right, it'll be good. We'll get nice and sweaty. All right, and we got this beautiful backdrop for y'all too today. So make sure you don't need any equipment. Make sure you have your water for this. Get ready to go. No equipment, just your body and water and fun spirit here. All right, so let's start with first, we're gonna go through four rounds of some squats. So just basic squats, get our body moving. Feet hip width apart, chest up, nice strong posture, belly button sucked in towards our spine, and let's start our first squat. Up and down, up and down. We're gonna do about 10 or 15 of these. Again, check in with your body, make sure that your cues are there, that your heels are down firmly planted on the ground, that my belly button is sucked right in, I'm engaging my core, and my chest is nice and tall. I'm not leaning forward in any way. I'm nice and aligned and nice posture. So let's do a few more of these. Take a little breather. I love the wind.
Yeah.
All right, let's take a little break. You can grab a drink of water, stretch out a little bit. I like to stretch out sometimes, especially when I first start the workout. I'm still sort of like thinking about all of my joints and what I haven't stretched all day. All right, let's get back into it. Let's do another 15, 20 squats. What do you say?
Sounds good.
Do it. All right.
Do you like to move your arms when you do it too, or would you recommend keeping it?
Either way. Yeah. I think either way works. Whatever is most comfortable for your body. I always like to check in with myself and think, hey, as long as my weight is on my heels and my posture is good and
maybe
I'm not leaning
forward.
Maybe
I think I'm doing
forward.
More if I add my arms.
Yeah. Your Apple Watch might feel that way.
Oh, you don't have one.
But I think about that instead of running. I'm like, I feel like maybe it's more work if I'm like, my Apple Watch thinks I'm doing more work.
Extra steps.
I know. All right, we'll get five more in here. I'm already breathing a little hard because I was sitting at a desk all day. Shake it out. Grab a drink of water. Grab your water. We're gonna do a couple more of these and then we'll go into another squat variation. I love showing people different squat variations because you can always add them to your repertoire and do them and never get sick of a squat because you always got a ton of squats to do. All right, tone glutes, tone quads, it's gonna get everything here for you. All right, let's do another 15 here. Ready? Last round. 15 more squats. Let's do this.
Where do you like to breathe in and out as you go in, as you go down, and as you go up?
You know, when I am doing body weight squats, really, I breathe. I don't really try to find it. I just breathe. As you lift heavier and heavier and add more weight, breathing definitely becomes more of an important factor, but for me, I just like to make sure I'm breathing.
I think
just
that's
don't hold your breath, and you're good to go. All right, I stopped counting, but let's say five more.
All right.
I think we all don't mind the extra burn, right? That's why we're here.
All right, good job. Grab a drink of water. I like to get a lot of water while I'm working out. Just a little sip. And then I'll show you another squat variation. This one is called split squats. And it's sort of like a lunge, but you're just standing there in a split position. So again, you're gonna be in sort of like a lunge position. We've all done a ton of lunges before. But instead of lunging each time, we're just going to keep this standing position and sink down. Sink down. Perfect. Make sure that our forward knee does not track over our forward foot. So I don't want to be leaning too far. I want to make sure that, again, the weight is on my heel. So we're going to do about 15 on each leg. And where you want to be feeling this is in your quad and your glutes, maybe your hamstrings. Tired, it's very easy to lose your posture. let's learn another squat variation called curtsy squats or curtsy lunges. So what you want to do here is essentially like you're doing a curtsy, like remember ballet? If you ever did ballet, maybe you've seen a ballerina do this before. This is an awesome squat to really work your glutes, those side glutes there. This is awesome for that. All right, ready? Let's start. We'll just do one side first, but you can also do this alternating sides as well. But notice how I'm still staying forward, standing forward each time. I'm not twisting. I'm still forward. And then I'm bringing my foot around and squatting down.
Feel it in that inner thigh.
Yes. Woo. All these squat variations are awesome because you really end up working a lot of different muscles, not just sort of. This one tends to be a little bit better movement for building strength in your glutes, whereas a traditional squat oftentimes will work your quads a little bit more. So that's why it's important to do different types of squat variations. All right, ready for the next side?
All right, let's start.
We got this. See how, so I'm a little bit weaker on my left leg, so I should have actually probably started with my left leg. It's okay. We're just out here having fun, moving.
Challenging ourselves.
Maybe let's do about 7 to 10 more, see how we feel. I hate counting. Everyone always asks me, how many do you want to do? And I feel like, you know what, it's less about the number, more about how you feel.
Ooh, I like that.
So just go about how you feel.
Probably can't
do one more
sometimes.
Do one more and then stop. All right. And five. Four, three, two, one. All right, we got this. All right, second round. Now that we know the movement,
heart rate's up.
We got this. All right, three, two, one, let's go. And again, if you're feeling like this movement might be a little bit more challenging, you don't have to go as deep in the squat. Make sure you're still facing forward and maintaining a tight core, belly button in towards your spine. But don't feel like you have to go super deep each time. You're still getting the benefits of the exercise. And let's do about five more. Two and one. All right, ready? Yeah. Second side. You got this. More confident this round. My leg feels a little less weak, but I'm still not going down quite as deep. But that strength will come, and I'm okay with that. And let's do five more. Four, three, two, one. All right. Yeah, get some water, take a break. It's very important to take breaks as you work out. Too quickly and then skip the last half of the workout. We want to make sure we have a lot of energy for the whole workout. We want to pace ourselves here. All right, ready for another round? You got this. Our glutes are going to be feeling it tomorrow, that's for sure.
I can get out of bed or not.
It's so pretty. I love this.
And hopefully this is the first of many exercises outdoors.
Exactly. Three, two, one. All right, switch. Don't make a sound. 2 a.m. low, gotta keep it down. Don't wait around for a second now. Give me some verb, I ain't talking now. You wanna ride in the six. You wanna dine in the six. But when I lean for the kiss, you said I'll probably send you some pics. And I'm not. Let's do five more. Been waiting too long. Hell no, I want that cool love.
Nice. All right, you take it out. Take the more squats I did. and muddier it got around.
I know. We gotta move around a little bit. Just gets muddier and muddier.
Alright, ready for
our last round here? Curtsy squats. We got this. Alright, let's go. So I'm really working on my strength on both sides, and it's really important too to ensure that your muscles are developing at the same rate and strength as you continue your routine. All right, good job. That was the last round of those. All right, so we did regular squats, we did split squats, we did curtsy squats. Now we're gonna do some elevated. So this is a more challenging movement than regular split squats. What we wanna do is do a rear foot elevated. So what we're doing is we're putting about, let's say, 3 or 4 feet away from whatever table, chair, bench you have to perform this movement. It's kind of challenging to get into this movement, but once you're there, you'll know. So you rest your foot on that bench, and you want to make sure as you're squatting down on that one leg that your foot is not tracking over your toe. Sorry, your knee is not tracking over your toe. So get in position. You might have to hop around a little bit. It's not finesse necessarily, but make sure you're in the right position. And then do your first squat, feel it out, see how that feels. I'm a little bit too forward, so I'm gonna make an adjustment. And then now it feels better in that second squat, so I know I'm in the right position. My knee is not tracking over my toe. And now I can do the squat. Do you have any questions about this one, Pat? Are you doing
okay? Oh, I'm feeling it. The only one thought was, better if your toes are on that ball of your foot.
I usually have the top of my foot because you kind of get a better balance, a more grip. So I do recommend that sort of core of your foot is on there. But also feel it out.
Lower too when that.
Yeah, you can get a little lower too. This movement primarily works your hamstrings and your glute. So if you feel that area of the body working and sort of more tension in that area, that's a good sign that you're likely doing it right. All right, let's do a couple more, and then we'll switch sides. And two. All right, switch sides. I'm gonna get on a non-bumpy grass.
Non-elevated lump.
Yeah. Again, it's okay to feel a little goofy getting into this position because you want to make sure you're in the right position.
No, the only good thing here is we can't see anybody.
I feel
can't
my
see you guys. Oh, we can't see each other.
I feel my glute working right here. Regular split squats that we did earlier instead of those. Totally fine. Just wanted to show you that there's a lot of variations of these squats that you can do.
Yeah, probably split with their
foot too. You can always practice that as well.
Probably start low to work
start
on the balance.
Low, yep. Work up. Ready for another round?
Let's do it.
All right. Got my wrong foot up there here. To be young and in love in New York City. And you don't have to go fast through these movements. I know everyone wants to kind of go super fast, but in actuality, the more time under tension, the more time your muscles have under the tension, the stronger they're getting. It's not about how fast you do it, it's how good you do it in terms of, it's not about how fast you do it, it's the technique, proper technique.
Quality over quantity.
Exactly.
Yeah.